Thanks and welcome. It's Kathleen from Cause Creations. Welcome to the No Bra Zone number 2, guys. Look what I got. I found this in a box that I'd been looking for, and I figured, you know what? It's destiny. I should use it. Those of you who have followed me know that I don't do Dutch pours. I sure admire them. They're not as easy as they look. There's some talented people out there, Canella and Rinska and Molly, who do just beautiful Dutch pours. And I thought to myself, let's just play. Now, I don't know if this is a Dutch pour just because I'm using a blow dryer. I don't just have a blow dryer. I found this cool little tool that I use for my alcohol inks that has a really good shot of air. I've got my handy dandy Puffy 2000 that I can manipulate it with. I have some straws, but once a week I go through my leftover paints. What I do is, you all know about my slop buckets where I scrape up my drippings from my paintings, and I generally put them in a cover container. I strain them and I reuse them, usually as my base coat colors, and sometimes the colors are magnificent. Well, my other paints, my swiping paints and my other pour paints, if I have even just a little bit left over, I scrape them out and I put them in these little containers with these lids, and they last such a good long time. But what I do is, if I have a little leftover blue and a little leftover green, I dump them together to make a different color. If I have a little bit of gold and maybe some nickel azo gold, I put them in a cup and I mix them together, and a lot of times I come up with some magnificent colors. So I'm not able to tell you what all of this is. This is a container of all my blue and my blue greens and my greens that I just got done mixing that were in these cups. This right here is just Artist Loft Soft Body in the white. And the only other one I can identify is this guy right here that's in the little bit of a bigger cup. And that's Satin Enamel, the Pure White by Deco Art. Excuse me, but all these colors are a bunch of different colors mixed up. I know this is probably turquoise and some Art Alchemy color. This is just some more of my base coat that I put in a cup to keep aside in case I need it as an eraser. This is probably golden green gold mixed with some green, another green, and some gold, and so on and so forth. Probably golden fluids in the gold fine and nickel azo gold. So these are all a bunch of different colors that were mixed together that were left over, and I thought to myself, what the heck, let's use them all up. Now, what I did have to do is I have to stir this up real good, because generally there's a few colors in there. I pour it into my little cup and then I doctor it up a little bit. Now, I know that these are all mixed with Liquitex pouring medium and Floetrol, because they're in that section on my little wall there where I store the Liquitex PM paints and I store the GAC 800 paints, so I can kind of keep track of the pouring medium. All Liquitex and Floetrol is probably 50-50 ratio. Put them into these little cups, check the consistency, and started to add water. How much water? I don't know. A good amount of water. But not as much as most people, because none of these are really heavy body paints. So the paints themselves were relatively fluid, but I added enough water till the paint rolls off that popsicle stick and just drizzles down and dissipates into the cup below. I would say a little bit thinner than my pearl pour paint. So I'm just gonna fiddle. I'm gonna whip out this blow dryer. I'm gonna use my my handy dandy little Puffy 2000, maybe my alcohol ink puffer, and put a couple of different base coats down. I'm just gonna fiddle. I'm gonna play, and hopefully we'll end up with something nice. And if it doesn't work out, Heck, we'll swipe it. All right, guys, let's put some tunes on. Let's get busy.
Time you and What's your type? Somehow I wanna know all about you. Deep connection, lights a spark. You already know me when we dance in the dark. We're dreamers.
We come alive.